you can have a piece of my love. It's waiting for you. Boy, it's true. You can have a piece of my love. Don't turn it off. Don't turn it off. Bro, you turn the morning inspiration like, what is she doing? No, I promise you. I promise you, it's got a point. Good morning. Welcome to Morning Inspiration with Just Joyce. I'm a performing arts educator, a creative, and a believer. And this is kind of like my chronicle as I'm going back in person for school. My school is going back. And I just basically talk about how God is encouraging me during this time. I'm talking about educator tips and all of that. So let me get to this song that I just sang this morning. So it was on my spirit. You know how when you were younger, you know, I grew up in the 80s. So it was kind of like, you know, you listen to these songs and you like the groove and you like the beat. You don't quite know what they're talking about. And so now that I'm an adult, I don't know why this was in my spirit. And I was like, oh, okay. Made me a little mad because I'm like, I don't want a piece of your love, bro. I'm gonna need you to give me everything. I want it all. Brand new socks and drawers. I'm really telling my age this morning. But now, you know, that really kind of hit me, you know, because I was like, who wants a piece? You know, I want your heart. You know, I want your mind. I want your body. I want all of it, you know, because I'm going to try my best to give you all. And to be honest, if we're really honest, that is not an easy task. You know, loving people and loving, you know, your person that you with or your lover, your spouse or whoever, that stuff, your family, that stuff is not easy at all. You know, and when you look at the word of God and it talks about, you know, in 1 Corinthians, and 12, that love is patient, love is kind, love does not envy, it's not proud, it doesn't boast, it's not rude, you know, it hopes all, it endures all. Oh my goodness, love is really difficult. It's really challenging if you're gonna do it right. Now if you do it TV version wise, you know, oh, I love you and it's all fluffy and you feel it all the time, and you know, and that, but that is not, that's not real love. Love endures all things, you know. And you know, when I'm thinking about this school year, you know, I am as an educator, educating children is challenging. It's really, really challenging. And you know, for those people who, you know, you know I know they don't think it now, but used to say, like, you know, all them teachers, you know, they ain't doing, you know, they get holidays off and they ain't barely doing anything. Now you know what it is. Especially you gotta teach your own children at the house, you know what it is. And when teachers teach, they do it for the love. I mean, you got some people in there that's doing it for the money, but the majority of people are doing it for the love. And when I think about some of the teachers at my school, I mean, like, some of the things that I've heard, folks going to people's houses, you know, taking assignments to kids, you know, going above and beyond. You know, my principal has been going above and beyond, you know, coming up with ideas to get kids, you know, in class and just really, you know, really just trying their best, you know. And I know everybody has a story of a teacher who has, you know, just pushed that envelope. You know, I have stories of teachers who went above and beyond. You know, I had this one teacher who was saying that I was supposed, you know, that I was, could not do certain things and I wasn't supposed to be in this reading group. You know, that's really important when you're in your primary level of, you know, grades. And there was another teacher who said, you know what, I believe she can do it, bring her to my class. And so, you know, come to find out, I was reading on a very high reading level. And my mom kept telling them, my baby can read. She can read, like, more than this first grade level. This and this. And this other teacher, she was like, bring her, second grade teacher, bring her to my class. And she was like, yeah, she's super intelligent. And I really praise God for people like that who go above and beyond and who love. Y'all, that's love. You know, when I think about, like, those of us who, whether you're completely virtual or where you're having to teach virtually and in person, y'all, that's the love. I mean, having to engage students both ways, oh my goodness. You know, and then those of us who are stepping out and taking health risks, and you're, you know, doing track and you're doing soccer and you're doing all this risking, doing band and, you know, stepping out, all this stuff. You know, we all have our comfort levels, don't get me wrong, you know, and I'm not saying that those who are not doing all the things don't love, but you know, we all have our personal sacrifices as educators. And so I just want to give it up for our educators, because y'all, we're doing the most right now. We are pushing, and I know your love level for your students is up there. So just be encouraged as you go on your work week, as you go on your day, and also for parents, you know, I know it's hard sending your kids back, you know, in person, and you know, but you know, it's things that we're having to do for survival purposes, you know. And so we just come to God. Let's go to God in prayer, because I know that we just keep trusting Him. He'll keep opening up doors. He's the ultimate example of true love, y'all. And so love has been on my heart this morning, you know. So let's just go to God in prayer. God, we thank You that You loved us so much that You gave Your only Son, Jesus Christ, Lord God. We thank You for the sacrifice that You gave for us, Lord God. And because You sacrificed, we can have life and have it more abundantly. And we say thank You, Lord God. Lord God, I pray, Lord God, right now for my brothers and sisters who don't know You, Lord God. I pray that You would strengthen them and let them know that the only thing that they have to do is believe that Your Son, Jesus Christ, died on the cross for our sins and then rose again. And if you just believe that, you are now saved, and I welcome you into the body of Christ. And if you are somebody and you're not really Christ sure about this whole Jesus Christ thing, please know that God loves you and He desires that you know Him, but He's not going to force you. And when you're ready, He's standing right there ready to receive you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, y'all. So I just, you know, love somebody on today. You know, I know it's hard, you know, but I promise you, it is well worth it. Love is so much better than hate, y'all. It takes so much energy to hate people. Just love them and do your best. And y'all, give people the benefit of the doubt, because this time has really been hard. But if we all do our part, you know, I'll do our part to mask it up. You know, I don't know your comfort level, if you want to do the vaccine, if you don't, you know. But, you know, let's just show each other some love. Give each other the benefit of doubt, because this time has been rough. And with that being said, y'all have an awesome day. And I will talk to y'all tomorrow. Bye.